Edvotech Instructional Videos presents Experiment 345, Exploring the Genetics of Taste, SNP Analysis of the PTC Gene Using PCR. Before beginning this experiment, you will need 1 cup containing 10 ml of saline solution, screw cap centrifuge tubes, snap top centrifuge tubes, 300 microliters of lysis buffer, 1 tube containing a PCR Edvo bead, 90 microliters of PTC primer, 1 tube of Hay3 restriction enzyme, 1x TBE buffer solution, UltraSpec agarose powder, CyberSafe DNA stain, 2 water baths, one set at 55 degrees Celsius, the other at 99 degrees Celsius, a thermal cycler, an electrophoresis apparatus with a power supply, disposable gloves, and automatic micropipettes with tips. Module 1. Isolation of DNA from human cheek cells. Step 1. Label an empty 1.5 ml screw cap microcentrifuge tube and a cup of saline with your lab group or initials. Step 2. Rinse your mouth vigorously for 60 seconds using the 10 ml saline solution in the cup. Expel this solution back into the same cup. Step 3. Swirl the cup gently to resuspend the cells. Transfer 1.5 ml of the cell solution into the screw cap tube with your initials. Step 4. Centrifuge the cell suspension for 2 minutes at full speed to pellet the cells. Pour off the supernatant, but be sure not to disturb the pellet. Step 5. Repeat steps 3 and 4 once more. Step 6. Resuspend the cheek cell pellet in 150 microliters of lysis buffer by pipetting up and down or by vortexing. Step 7. Cap the tube and place it into a 55 degrees Celsius water bath for 5 minutes. Step 8. Mix the sample by vortexing or by flicking the tube vigorously for 20 seconds. Step 9. Incubate the sample in a 99 degrees Celsius water bath for 5 minutes. Step 10. Centrifuge the cellular lysate for 2 minutes at full speed. Step 11. Transfer 50 microliters of the supernatant to a clean, labeled snap-top microcentrifuge tube and place the tube on ice until needed. Module 2. Amplification of the PTC region. Step 1. Obtain the extracted DNA from Module 1. Step 2. Label a fresh 0.2 ml PCR tube with your initials. Step 3. Add 40 microliters of PTC primer mix and 10 microliters of extracted DNA from Module 1 to the labeled tube containing the PCR bead. Step 4. Mix the PCR sample. Make sure that the PCR Edvo bead is completely dissolved. Step 5. Centrifuge the tube for a few seconds to collect the sample at the bottom of the tube. Step 6. Amplify the DNA using the following PCR conditions. Initial denaturation at 94 degrees Celsius for 4 minutes, 35 cycles at 94 degrees Celsius for 30 seconds, 65 degrees Celsius for 30 seconds, and 72 degrees Celsius for 30 seconds, with a final extension of 72 degrees Celsius for 5 minutes. Once complete, the sample can be frozen until you are ready to perform the next module. Module 3, Restriction Digest of the PTC PCR product. Step 1, add 25 microliters of PCR amplified DNA to the tube containing 5 microliters of Hay3 restriction enzyme. Save the remaining 25 microliters of uncut PCR product to set up as a control later on. Step 2, gently mix the restriction digest Hay3 tube. Step 3, quickly centrifuge to collect the sample at the bottom of the tube. Step 4. Incubate the digest for 30 minutes at 37 degrees Celsius. Module 4. Separation of DNA fragments by electrophoresis. Step 1. Mix the agarose powder with 1x TBE buffer. Step 2. Dissolve the agarose powder by boiling the solution. Microwave the solution on high for 1 minute. Continue to heat the solution in 15-second bursts until the agarose is completely dissolved. The solution should be clear, like water. Step 3. Cool the agarose to 60 degrees Celsius by carefully swirling the flask to promote even dissipation of heat. Step 4. While the agarose is cooling, seal the ends of the gel casting tray with the rubber end caps. place the comb in the appropriate notch. Step 5. Before casting the gel, add 25 microliters of diluted CyberSave to the cooled molten agarose and swirl the flask to mix. Step 6. Pour the cooled agarose solution into the prepared gel casting tray. The gel should thoroughly solidify within 20 minutes. Step 7. Carefully remove the end caps and comb. Take particular care when removing the comb and end caps to prevent damage to the newly formed wells. Step 8. Place the gel and tray into an electrophoresis chamber. Cover the gel with 1x TBE electrophoresis buffer. The gel should be completely submerged. Step 9. Load the DNA samples into the wells, following the table in the kit instructions. DNA ladder, control DNA, undigested DNA, and digested DNA. Step 10. After all samples are loaded into the gel, check that the gel is properly oriented and then place the safety cover onto the chamber. Step 11. Connect the leads to the power supply and perform electrophoresis. Step 12. After electrophoresis is complete, remove the gel and casting tray from the electrophoresis chamber. Step 13. Slide the gel off the casting tray onto the viewing surface of a transilluminator and turn the light on. The DNA should appear as bright green bands on a dark background. Photograph the results for later analysis. Module 5. Determination of bitter tasting ability with PTC paper. Step 1. Taste the control paper first and record what you taste. Step 2. Taste the PTC strip of paper and record what you taste. Step 3. Compare the taste of the control and PTC paper. Analyze the results. Congratulations! You have now successfully completed Experiment 345, Exploring the Genetics of Taste, SNP Analysis of the PTC Gene Using PCR.